What is the significance of the particular design of some of the gear? For instance, the loincloth effect and the bondage garments.
Well, basically, the whole look of these things, it's really an urban guerrilla look. But it has got certain gestures towards tribalism. That's where the little loincloth comes in. And a little kilt is what I'm wearing. That's an alternative over these trousers. They've got lots of details in them. Zips. And there's a strap that goes round the leg that looks restricting, but it's not. It's a question of expressing some kind of emotion through the line and shape and form of these clothes. A get-up-and-go feel. We've always been attracted to a very active feeling in our clothes. I was prosecuted for a T-shirt last year. I think that... if you want to find out how free you are in England, the easiest way to find out quickly is to make an overt sexual statement, and you do soon find that that is what disturbs people more than anything, more than a political one, in fact. I think this country is about making bombs, not at the moment, anyway. And so you have to attack it through the media, really. And clothes are a very exciting thing that appeal to kids, and I'm interested in kids. Or anybody who feels like a kid. I mean, I'm 36 years old and I still walk on walls when I walk down the street. I don't walk in a normal way and stuff.
They let me travel first class with my second class ticket every day from Lewes to Seaford because of the trouble they knew I was having. So they were really sweet about that.